Good morning, one and all. My name is Saumil Shah. I work as a software engineer. In this tutorial series, I'm going to be teaching you from complete zero to hero in AWS S3. So we'll be learning the fundamental of an S3 bucket, how a bucket is created using Python, of course, Boto3, how we can delete one, how we can get all the buckets, how we can go inside a bucket and get the list items. We'll learn also about the paginator object in an S3 bucket. We'll learn how to read items from a bucket. We'll learn how to write items from a bucket. And we'll basically perform all the basic CRUD operation on bucket. So hope you are excited and to join me in this course. So without further wasting any much time, let's get started with this tutorial series. So the first step is basically we need to create AWS S3 credentials. So hopefully you have your Amazon Web Services. Go to IAM section. And the very first thing that you need is basically some credentials or access key. So head over to the user section, click on add user. Now name this user here. So I'm going to say test. And for this project or for the learning AWS S3, we'll make sure that we have the admin privilege. So next. Okay, so existing roles and policy and select administrative access. Next, tags. So tags are very important. So let's add, basically we'll say YouTube learn. Okay, so now I'm gonna click on the next and review. So now basically we have administrative access and so let's click on the create user. So now this is a very important step. We need to copy this AWS access key and the secret key here. So make sure to copy it in a file. That is the step number one. And in the next step, basically we'll write some Python script basically to create an S3 object or basically create a bucket. So let's learn how to create a bucket on Amazon Web Services using Programmatic, that is Python Boto3. So I am on my AWS console here. You can go ahead and create a bucket. So I'm gonna be showing you that, but we will use Programmatic. You can of course click on the create bucket object. You can name a bucket and click on the next and the bucket would be created. But we don't wanna do that. Instead, we wanna use Programmatic approach to create a bucket. So let's do that. So the first step is basically define Boto3. If you haven't installed Boto3, make sure to install it. So I'm gonna write some comments for you here. So you would basically simply say, enter this command here on Anaconda or wherever you are doing. Okay, so this is how you would install the Boto3. Now the first thing that we need to do is basically we need to create a client object. So the way you can do that is using Boto3 client S3. Then you can say you need to provide the access key, the secret key, and the region in which we are working. For the project, I'm going to be working on AWS. I'm going to be working on the US East one. Okay, and I have my credentials here, which is stored in a file called as secret.txt file. Now let us learn how to create a very simple bucket. So once you have a client object ready, if you print a client object, you would get basically, let me run this first of all. So you will get a Boto3 client object, right? That's fine. Now we need to create a bucket. So to create a bucket, basically we can use the command create bucket. So once you have the client object, okay, so client.create bucket, ACL equals to private. That means the type of access to the bucket is going to be public or private, right? So I'm saying it's going to be a private. You can leave it to public as well. And then the bucket name, remember you have to give a name of a bucket. The bucket name has to be unique globally. So I just said, I usually use a date time. So the way I do it is basically like this. So let me actually show you. So I'm going to do this. So let's make sure the capital is turned off. So date time dot date time. Let me just do that. So what I did is basically the month, the day and the year, I combine everything and I create a number. That's going to be my bucket's name. So let me say bucket name. So I'm going to say my bucket name as this. Okay, so this is going to be my bucket name. So now instead of your me hard coding that. I'm gonna replace that with a variable bucket name. Then create configuration. This is where you wanna the location constraint. Let me change this to US East 1 because we are using US East 1. So hopefully that everything is correct. And when you run this, you should be creating a bucket on Amazon Web Services. So let me actually run this code. And we do get an error. It says error occurred while creating a constraint when calling create bucket operation. The specified location constraint is not valid. So, I mean, let's try the West one then. Now that did work. So the US West one did work. So now what I'm going to do is basically, I'm going to be clicking on the response. So this basically gives me a response saying that my bucket was basically created. Here you can see Saumil Shah, the date .s3.amazon.com location, right? So if I go to my Amazon S3 and if I simply refresh it, here you can see the bucket has been created, right? Saumil Shah and the number that we just appended. So it was created in the US West, not California, at this basically date and time. So that's how you would create a bucket in basically Python. That's how you would create a bucket in Amazon Web Services using Python Boto 3. Now, in the second part, let's learn how to delete a bucket. So in order to delete a bucket, you need to create a resource object. So basically, for creating a bucket, we use the client object. Now for deleting a bucket, we will use the resource object. So the first thing that we need to do is basically define a bucket. We need to specify the name of the bucket that we want to delete. In this case, it's going to be Saumil Shah 74, whatever this number. And then I'm just going to call the bucket.delete on it. After running this, it gives me a response here, a JSON response. And if I go to my Amazon Web Services console, and if I refresh it, that bucket should be gone. So here you can see that bucket has been deleted. So let's review this. So I'm going to add a comment here. Okay. So for creating a bucket, we used a client object. For deleting a bucket, we used an AWS Boto 3 resource object. So let me conclude here. So I'm going to say notes. Let me write that. So for creating buckets, we used AWS. We used Boto 3 client object. And for deleting the bucket, we use resource object. Okay, so far so good. So basically, we learned how to create a bucket. We learned how to create a bucket basically using a client object. Then we learned how to delete a bucket using AWS Boto 3 resource object. Now, let's see how to get all the elements from the buckets, right? So now, basically what we learned is basically how to create a bucket using a client object. We learned how to delete a bucket using a resource object. Now, let's try to learn how to get all the elements from the buckets. What I mean by that is, I want to get all the buckets that is available in my AWS account. So there is a command. What you can do is, first of all, we need to create a resource object. So you can see I've created a resource object. Now I want to grab all the buckets. So I can say for buckets in s3.buckets.all. Now what I would do, I would say buckets. So if you print here, you can see it prints all the name of the buckets that is there on my Amazon Web Services. But how do I get the name? It's an object, right? I can't grab the name out of it. So simple, you can just use dot operator and you can say dot name. This would give you the list of all the buckets. If you want this as a list, you can use a list comprehension. I mean, I would say something like buckets is equal to, I would say for buckets in, I would say s3.buckets.all, I would say here, and then I would just populate this with basically buckets.name attribute. Instead of writing a for loop, I would do that on a single line. Now I can simply print the buckets. Hopefully should work, and seems to have a small issue here. Now you can see I have a list element with all the buckets. So now let's learn how to upload a file on a bucket. So I say os.listr, which basically gives me a list of files on my computer. In this, I want to upload a file called as resume.pdf. Remember one thing, whenever you upload files on an S3 bucket, it has to be a binary. Okay. So basically I use open, I open the file and I read it as a binary object. Now I can actually prove that this is a binary. So now if I say type data, so it's a byte. And if I say the length, this is the length of the data. Now you want to upload that file on the bucket, right? So you would say Boto3, you would create a client object. Then you would say response is equal to client.put object. ACL is basically the type that you want. I want that file to be a private. Body is basically the bytes data. Bucket is basically the bucket name on your stuff. Key is basically the name of the file. Okay. So when I run this, so here you can see it's processed. And now if I go to S3, I don't have any files. I'm going to refresh. Hey, I have your resume. Now, if you want this resume into a folder called as PDF, what you could have done is you in the key section, say PDF and just say slash. Now, if I run this again, it's going to upload the file. If I refresh here, the folder has been created. Now, if I go to that folder, it's inside the folder. So this basically, this is how you would insert an item or you would create folders in an S3 bucket, right? All right, so now let's learn basically how to delete that file. So we basically inserted that file onto an S3, right? Now let us learn how can we even delete that file. So if you see on the S3 bucket, we did upload my resume, right, on my bucket. Let me actually refresh it. I might have to log in again because the session might have ended. Oh, so yeah, it's fine. So I'm gonna go to the bucket and here you can see resume.pdf. Let me show you how to delete an item and then we'll also see other things. So in order to delete items from an S3 bucket, the Boto3 allows you to do that and it has an API called as client object. So you create a client object first. So copy that. After you create a client object, then you would say delete_object. That's the syntax that you want to use it. So I'm going to show you how to use that. Now basically the bucket is basically the bucket name. So let me go to my Amazon web console, copy that. That one right here. Now the image, basically the key is basically the why you want to delete. So I want to delete resume.pdf, which is not in the folder. Okay. So let's say resume PDF. Version ID string is fine, quiet, true, false, leave everything to default. Now what happens is basically, sorry if my microphone was a little that side. Now basically if I try to observe, okay, it's still there, okay. Now let me run the command. So I ran the command. If I check the response, okay, we have a success. And now if I refresh, this should go away, okay. If everything was worked correctly, then this should go away. Oh, it did not go away for some reason. We have an error and it says resume.pdf, no such versions or file. Okay, let's try to see what happened actually. So the bucket name is correct. Version ID, I mean, wanna get rid of that one. We don't need that. So let me see. It is resume.pdf, okay. So let's try again. Now I think it's okay. So now we got our response back. Now let's try to refresh it again and see. So refresh and you see the resume folder is gone. This is how you would delete an item from an S3 bucket. So basically you would create a client object and then you would say delete object. Now let me show you how to get all the objects from a bucket. So let me how to get all the objects. Okay, so in order to do that we have to use something called as list objects. So we create a client object as usual, so that remains the same. Now after creating a client object, we'll say list object. let me show you. And then we say the bucket name. So let me actually copy the bucket name. Remember, there are two files, okay? So you're right here, gonna paste that, and let's run this and see what happens. So response, and if you see the key here, right, the in the contents directory, you can of course iterate over that JSON. And if you grab the key here, you can see that's the key, and it gives all the metadata as well, like when was this last modified and stuff like that. So this is how you can get all the objects from the bucket. So once again, you create a client object, then you say list objects, and then you would grab all the objects from the buckets. Another important thing that I want to talk about is the paginator object in an S3 bucket. So if you want to crawl in a particular directory or a folder, or if you want to grab more than 1,000 files, the list objects won't work. You have to do a pagination. So AWS Boto3 allows that, and it's called as the pagination object. So first of all, you have to create a client object. Then you create a paginator. You say client.getPaginator list objects v2. That's the version of the which we are going to use. Then we say pages equal to paginator.paginate, provide the bucket name and the prefix. Prefix means basically where the paginator should look. In this case, I'm saying, hey, look specifically in the PDF folder. I don't want it to look anywhere else, only in that directory. So I say PDF slash. So now the paginator object is only going to look into that. But if you print that, it's going to give you a BotoCore object because it's a generator. They use generator behind the scenes in order to get value. So you would say for page in pages, for object in page.contents, you would append the key. And if you print that temp, you would get the files in that particular directory only. That is about the AWS paginator object. How to get items from a bucket, basically how to read that. So I have this file called as my resume, which is in the folder called as PDF. So Boto3 has an object called as get object. So first of all, you need to create a client object. Once you create a client object, then you can say client.get object. And remember, the data is usually a binary. Okay, we have an issue here, I think because of the indentation. Let's correct that. Okay, so when I say response new, remember it's gonna give me the JSON data, but you see the body, right? That's what we are interested in. So that's my resume. So I'm gonna grab the body here. Okay, now remember it's a Boto3 core object, right? So if you want to read data, it's a generator object, remember. So data is equal to this. So if you want to read it, you have to call the read method on that. Okay, now if I call that and if I say length of data, it's gonna be a big, you know, because it's a blob object. Okay, so I can also show you by saying type of data. Now what you can do is with open new resume.pdf. What we want to do is write binary. So if you want to store it, f.write, and we'll write the data into it. So hopefully that was done. Now actually let me show you that my resume would be there. So my PC, head over to the desktop, personal projects, new resume.pdf. So if I open it, here you can see my resume, which is downloaded from AWS S3. So this is how you would get an item.
So first of all, before even doing anything, you need to install these dependency. So pip install fastparquet, P-A-R-Q-U-E-T. I don't know how to pronounce it properly. And you need to install PyArrow and S3FS. Make sure to install that. Without that, if you run it, might get errors, and I'm not responsible for that. All right. So the very first thing that we need to do is, first of all, we need to define some libraries. Import Boto3. After that, and finally the IO. All right, so the libraries are installed correctly, and now what we need to do is basically we need to define our bucket name and the file name that we want to do. Let's do that. Alright, so the bucket name is sawmillshah1995 bucket, and the file name, or let me just walk you through that once again, because you will say, hey, you did not teach us that. So here I have a bucket, I go to the bucket, right? And in that bucket, I have a file known as my.park, right? Park A file. Now I will go to the overview. Let me see. Let me just go back quickly. So I go to the bucket, right? Now I'm searching for the file. So park 8 file. Before even doing, go to permissions and allow read write access. Okay. So for the very first thing, go to overview section. Make sure to copy the key right here, my park 8. Right. Go to your Boto 3 now. Right. Now replace the file name with the file name of your park A file. This is the bucket name. Now, once done that, we need to define some stuff. Let's define a buffer. So I'm gonna say buffer IO bytes IO. All right. Now, after creating a buffer, we need to create a Boto 3 object. Client.resource. Why it's not auto completing? All right. Let me just copy that. Alright, so we define our resource object. Then what do we need to do is basically we need to create an object. Object is equal to client dot object, capital O, remember that, object. Once done that, we want to give you a bucket name. Bucket name followed by the file name. Once done that, what you want to do is basically you want to say object dot download, so download underscore file obj, and just pass in your buffer. Once done that, you can call your pandas read underscore parquet and pass your buffer, and at the end print your df. Let's try to run it and see if we can read directly the file from the S3 bucket. So here you see directly I was able to read the file from the S3 bucket, that is a parquet file from the S3 bucket using pandas module. So these are the steps. Before even doing that, these are the dependency. Make sure to install it. Let's move straight into S3 buckets. Let me show you my bucket. I have this bucket known as sawmillshah1995 bucket, right? And I have this data set known as USA Housing CSV. Now, without downloading, how can I read it directly from an S3 bucket? So let me show you a tutorial on how to do that, right? So let me go to the bucket. I'm gonna go to the data set first of all, because we need to give some permissions. So go to permissions, click here, and make sure you give the read and write permission. And click on the save button right there. Now go back to the overview. Now do not copy this entire URL. If you do, you will get errors. Okay, so please don't do that, right? So with the very first thing is we need to import the Boto 3. All right, now that's done. Now once that is done, we need to create a so once Boto 3 is installed, we need to create a client object. So let me go ahead and do that for you. So here is a client object, right? Boto 3 client S3. Now once that is done, right? Now we want to directly read the CSV, right? So now we'll define a path, and this path would be your bucket name. This should be the only path. Remember, if you do something else, you'll get error and it won't work. So the S3 bucket double slash the name of your bucket. So the name of my bucket is the name of the bucket, and slash the key name. This is the format, okay? If you do something else, you'll get error, okay? So copy the key name. All right, looks good. Run that. Df is equal to pd.readcsv path. Now run that. Now I want to tell you one more thing that if you run this, you will get error. Now, why? Let me tell you that. All right, here you can see directly I was able to read the data from the Amazon Web Services. You might fall into error, so in that case, you have to install one module. Let me write it right here. So just type this command pip install s3fs. This is very important. If you do not have this module, it will give you an error. Okay. So install this. So just do pip install s3fs and then you should be good. So here you see how I can read CSV file directly from Amazon Web Services, AWS.